是爷爷不老实。
Praise the name of Jesus. We are so delighted that you have just watched Kingdom Impact Production. That is right. This is your host, Dr. Kilafu Kali, and we are from Kingdom Apostolic Ministries International here in beautiful Freeport, Grand Bahama. We are exploding. God has truly blessed us. We are live and we are on the air. We are determined to take this gospel of the kingdom. And when this gospel of the kingdom, Jesus said, is preached to the ends of the earth as a witness unto all nations, then the end will come. We believe we have a great responsibility here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries in preaching, teaching, worshiping, and prophetically declaring this gospel around the world. Lives are being transformed. People are being delivered, healed, and transforming their personal lives. We have so many testimonies. Thank you for watching us. Please tune in to your regular station or on our online platform. All the information will be given to you to contact us, to go on our website, to buy products from our wonderful store and list of teaching. We love you in Jesus' name. We kindly ask you to pray for us, to intercede for us, to stand in the gap with us as we work together as God's people, to touch one life at a time until we reach the world. We have a passion to reach the entire globe. I know we can do it. God has given us the mandate to do it. Thank you again for watching Kingdom Impact Production. Dr. Kilafu Kali, Kingdom Apostolic Ministries here in Freeport. We love you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. We get ready for the word of the Lord. I want you to sit back and receive this wife, my wonderful wife, my darling wife, the woman of God, prophetess, preacher, teacher, intercessor, my love, my sugar, my honey, God's vessel, God's servant, prophetess Shaleva Kali, the woman of God who has the word of the Lord, a timely word in this month as we deal with healing and miracles and the supernatural power of God. Would you be blessed today as the Lord ministers to her and through her to you, us, and our God's people today. In Jesus' name. Welcome as she comes.
Love drinking. Hallelujah. Some person choose to go clubbing and partying and doing the dirtiest and filthiest and nastiest things. But for the grace of God, amen, he shed his blood that we can be redeemed. And not only that, amen. It's miraculous that for someone who used to be in those things, for the Lord to use them, amen, to wash them up and to clean them up,
yes,
amen, to give them
Hallelujah.
A new name, to allow their past to remain in the past, amen, that they move on to the future, to his promises and prosperity, amen. Look at, hallelujah, the lady at the well, the woman at the well, look at the life that she used to live, amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. But Jesus came and Jesus demonstrated his power unto her. She wanted to be saved. She wanted to drink, hallelujah, from that well that she never thirsts. Amen.
Yes.
And before long, as she grasped that concept, she ran back to the town. Everybody forgot what she used to do and how she used to be and everything. Amen. But they knew her. Amen. As the woman who brings salvation unto
yes.
them, a woman who opened up a door, amen, for them to receive healing
amen.
And deliverance. And that too, hallelujah, is a miracle. Glory be to the name of the Lord for him to change your name. Glory. Hallelujah. Can you imagine if she was like, oh, I don't know what you're talking about, water.
Mm.
What water this is? Let me see this water and carry
yes.
it. What you mean? What you mean there's water that will never run dry and that I will never be thirsty? What kind of water is that? I don't want that. You can keep that for yourself or give that to somebody else. Amen. But the woman of the well was ready. And because of her obedience and her drawing and pulling, hallelujah, from our Lord, that others was able to be saved this morning. Hallelujah. The God that we serve is a God who performs miracles and demonstrates his mighty power among his people. Amen. Hallelujah. It is there. Hallelujah. It is there for us to tap into and for us to receive. Hallelujah. But if we reject God and is walking out of God's will, hallelujah, we will never see his miracles manifested, hallelujah, in our lives. I ask you again, is there anything too hard for God this morning? Glory be to the name of the Lord. Remember the works, hallelujah, of our God. Hallelujah. When we do this, it will help us to avoid a lack of faith concerning his promise. Amen. The Lord God does not change. So if things seem to be off course, amen, it is not God, people of God. If things are off course, then it is you who is off course, and it is not God, because he never changed. And if we are to remember, hallelujah, the wonderful, mighty works of God, hallelujah, yes, we wouldn't be bound and disgruntled, and the enemy would have no room to come in, amen, and take us for a ride down destruction lane, amen. He does not change, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. So if things are changed, then it's you. Check yourself to see if you have changed somewhere along the line. Amen. Hallelujah. He is faithful when we are not. He is righteous in all of his ways. Amen. He does not change like the wind. Amen. Or like the deep waters that cannot be understood. Amen. If you think about the ocean out there that is so vast, there are millions of creatures, hallelujah, that have not been identified yet, that have not been recognized by scientists, hallelujah, as yet. Can you imagine, hallelujah, the things that are out there? Year by year, we see, hallelujah, that they discover more and more creatures, yes, creatures, hallelujah, that live so far in the deep. Hallelujah, that they are blind. They don't even see light. Hallelujah. The only that which is mysterious. Hallelujah. The Lord, hallelujah, is not like that where you have to figure him out. He gave you his book. Hallelujah. He gives you, hallelujah, his angels of the house to preach and to minister, to revelate his word unto you, that you may be filled, that the mysteries, hallelujah, may be unlocked. Hallelujah. But if you are not faithful, if you don't worship him, hallelujah, and recognize and give him praise for his wonderful and marvelous work, hallelujah, you will never, hallelujah, receive of that miracle. Hallelujah. I like what the psalmist said when he declared, hallelujah, your way, O God, is holy. What God is like our God? Blessed be the God of wonders, wondrous deeds. Hallelujah. He saves for the sake of his name, to make his power known. I say again, remember his marvelous work. Amen. His right hand is glorious in power. When we are in trouble, we can call upon him,
yes,
and ask him to awake, oh God, hallelujah, and put on your strength. Not only does he put on his strength, but he gives his strength unto you. Hallelujah. Isaiah 7 and 14 and Matthew 1 and 23 says, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign, hallelujah, the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel, hallelujah. The Bible begins with one of God's greatest miracle, which is the creation of the universe, amen. He formed the world by the power of his word. Amen. As the Spirit of the Lord hovered over, hallelujah, the earth, there was nothing. It was without form and it was void. And the Lord said, let there be. Hallelujah. And all of that came, hallelujah, into being. Amen. He hardened Pharaoh's heart so that he can meet his demise. Amen. The Israelite walked across the sea, amen, with water on both sides, amen, from the book of Exodus, chapter 14, 7 to 23, hallelujah, and 23 to 28, glory be to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And even as the Israelites walked across, amen, Moses being their leader, they followed and they believed. They were all on one accord. Hallelujah. Even though at first they were in doubt. Hallelujah. The Lord opened up the seas. Glory be to the name of the Lord for them to walk over on dry land. And even as they were going across, there was Pharaoh, amen, who gathered all of his horses, his horsemen and his chariot. And the Bible, hallelujah, said he gathered all of them. So all of the chariots, all of the horses, all of the men of war, amen, were gathered up and they followed Pharaoh in pursuit of the Israelites, amen. Yes. And even as they walked across, the Lord told Moses, amen. But even before then, amen, as they were looking back and complaining, amen, Moses went to the Lord on their behalf.
Yes.
And Moses said, and the Lord said unto Moses, why are you crying out to me? Why are you looking, amen, up unto me? He have already gave them the instructions. The Lord said, go forth, amen, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Glory. And even as they go forth, the Lord told them to put, hallelujah, the rod down. And the sea, amen, came back together. And so Pharaoh and all, because the word of God says all of those men of war, all of them, glory be to the name of the Lord, were destroyed. Amen. On that day. Hallelujah. I give this example, hallelujah, of miracles. Yes, I'm going to talk about the blind. Hallelujah. Who was able to see, the lame. Hallelujah. Who was able to walk, the woman with the issue of blood. Hallelujah. Who was hemorrhaging that the Lord caused to stop. But I want to talk about these, hallelujah, type of miracles that are warfare miracles, hallelujah, today. Because I want to strengthen your heart today. I want to strengthen you, hallelujah, for this battle, hallelujah, that you may be facing today. I want to remind you of the word of God that says the battle is not yours, it is the Lord. I want to remind you today to remain steadfast. Remain on the path that the Lord have placed you on. Remain, hallelujah, in the house of worship that the Lord has placed you in, hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the enemy, hallelujah, he is coming in like a flood. You ought to be vigilant and to know, hallelujah, if you have received your miracles, if you are receiving breakthrough, hallelujah, then you don't want to show up, then you don't want to go out. Then the enemy comes in and encourages you to visit other places. It is a trap of the enemy. The only way your enemies, hallelujah, will be destroyed is if you remain steadfast.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Remain on one accord. Hallelujah. You follow your leader. Hallelujah. The only way that you would get healing and deliverance, hallelujah, this morning and see your enemies destroyed is if you follow the word of the Lord and remain steadfast.
Hallelujah.
I want to let some of you know this morning that many of your enemies, hallelujah, they're about to be destroyed, hallelujah. The Lord is going to destroy them by fire. This morning, the Lord is going to destroy them, hallelujah, by water. This morning, where they are going to be drowned, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory be to the name of the Lord. This week, hallelujah, I was seeing, hallelujah, visions and dreams. Most of them took me, hallelujah, by the seas, hallelujah, this morning. And most of the people, hallelujah, who I was seeing, they were professionals, hallelujah. But not only that, they would have seemed familiar because of the profession that the Lord showed me. But all of them were clothed in white. Hallelujah.
Yes.
This morning. And not only were they clothed in white, the Lord had me to see miraculous beauty of his creation. Hallelujah. His animals, his sea creatures dancing, hallelujah, and frolicking and performing, doing a performance, hallelujah, before my very eyes.
Yeah.
And even as I walked up, hallelujah, on close to that shore, hallelujah, the Lord had me going to a property, hallelujah, which was mine, which was located on the seashore. But even as I was going towards that property, those persons was lying off, hallelujah, in their white clothing, hallelujah, and they were looking at at me, hallelujah. They were greeting me with honor, hallelujah, and respect. Hallelujah, glory be to the name of the Lord. And even as they greeted me as I walked past, because I had everybody's attention, I see that there were those who were in their big hats as though it was a celebration. There was a stage, hallelujah, that was already set. There was someone, hallelujah, who was coming up and going towards the stage. Glory be to the name of the Lord. The Lord want us to know, hallelujah, honey, that the stage is already set.
Oh,
and those, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord, who were watching and waiting and thought that we would meet our demise. Hallelujah. And even for you people out there, the Lord, hallelujah, just has brought them together. That's all the Lord did, brought them together. Hallelujah. My husband was not there yet because the Lord had the place and everything prepared. It was being prepared for his coming. Hallelujah. For he was the one, hallelujah, who is about to grace and adorn, hallelujah, that stage, hallelujah. He was the one, hallelujah, who is to be the showstopper. Glory be to the name of the Lord. The promotion, hallelujah, has already been released to you. Hallelujah, my dear. And not only that promotion, but promotions have been released unto you. Hallelujah. And it is going to be your enemies, hallelujah, because of how the Lord had them set up, hallelujah. They themselves, hallelujah, will be looking unto you and will be honoring you. The party, hallelujah, is going to be to celebrate you, hallelujah. There ain't going to be no party, hallelujah, anymore, hallelujah, to go against, hallelujah, or to stop any show because of what the enemy is trying to plot and ploy in the name of Jesus. No, the party is going to be, hallelujah, where just some and not those enemies who are so grievous and want you dead. The Lord is going to kill all of them.
Hallelujah.
You're going to see it. Hallelujah. Yes. But those, hallelujah, who the Lord is still working on because of their hearts and because of prayer. Hallelujah. They will be the one who has no choice but to celebrate you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because every line, hallelujah, that is owed to you, every party and every celebration, everything that has cause for celebration,
hallelujah,
that you were to receive, hallelujah, it has been received. Hallelujah. And they shall be celebrating you. Glory be to
hallelujah.
The name of the Lord. And for some of you who are listening out there, hallelujah, that fire that you think that the enemy has been placing under you, as they would say, fire under your tail, the Lord is about to destroy your enemies with them same fire. You're going to see a switch
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Even as the Lord, hallelujah, when he was taking, hallelujah, the Israelites out of Egypt, hallelujah, with the pillar of cloud, hallelujah, and the fire. And at times they switch position, hallelujah, they alternate around them to lead them and to guide them. And as the presence of the Lord was there with them, hallelujah, there's going to be a switch, hallelujah. Those who were putting fire upon you, they are going to be the ones, hallelujah, receiving that fire, hallelujah. Those, hallelujah, who wish for your demise, wish for you to be drowned, they are the ones who is going to be drowned, hallelujah. They're going to be drowned with confusion. They're going to be drowned, hallelujah, because of the joy, hallelujah, that the Lord has placed upon your life, because of the prosperity that you are going to walk in, hallelujah, because of the wealth, because of the favor that the Lord is about to put upon your life,
hallelujah.
It's going to be, hallelujah, like the heavens, hallelujah, when the heaven is open up and pouring down, hallelujah, blessing and pouring down showers, hallelujah. The enemy is going to be drowned by all that favor and that showers of blessing that the Lord is about to place upon you. I tell you this morning to get ready.
Yeah.
I tell you and urge you this morning, do not forget, hallelujah, forget not the marvelous things that the Lord has done for you, because even in this, hallelujah, that too is the miracle of the Lord, hallelujah. When you continue to remember the things that the Lord has done for you, and you continue to give Him praise, and you continue to give Him worship, hallelujah, that is also a weapon of warfare, hallelujah. And even as you wage your weapons of warfare against the enemy, and the enemy is destroyed, hallelujah, you will continue to see the miraculous power, hallelujah, of the Lord, hallelujah. Even as we were in here last week, hallelujah, casting out demons, hallelujah, and doing the work of the Lord, hallelujah. Even before that day, hallelujah, as I was driving in the car, the Spirit of the Lord came upon me and I started speaking, hallelujah, in tongues. I felt the Lord moving on me, hallelujah, and I said, yes, a principality has been torn down. I said, breakthrough is coming, hallelujah. And I know before the breakthrough, hallelujah, before you receive that promise, before you receive that gift, hallelujah, you have to fight, you have to go through war. And I know even as we were in it, as my husband has declared, hallelujah, as we were here fighting, hallelujah, the Lord's fighting battle, hallelujah, on the Lord's behalf, just being His agents, hallelujah, hallelujah, and doing what the Word said, because the battle is the Lord. And even as it was declared that there were 10,000 angels, hallelujah, doing deliverance, hallelujah, in this place, I know that even a higher level of breakthrough, hallelujah, has come. And I know, hallelujah, even as we go up another level, hallelujah, in the spirit, I know that in the natural that we're about to go up even a greater level, hallelujah. Some people may not understand, hallelujah, how we are moving, and they try to figure us out, hallelujah. But I tell you that the Lord have them confused, because what they think, hallelujah, the Lord has switched up everything, hallelujah. They only seeing us, hallelujah, just so. I can tell you, people of God, they're not seeing you, hallelujah, in the spiritual realm where the Lord has you. They're not seeing you, hallelujah, in the light or in lieu of where the Lord has you strategically placed. Because the enemy, hallelujah, has been defeated, hallelujah. Those enemies that you think that you would have seen, hallelujah, some of them aren't even your enemies, because the Lord have already destroyed them, hallelujah. You think they're your enemies. You don't even have to worry about them, because they are so insignificant and so powerless, hallelujah. You have higher heights, hallelujah, to go to, hallelujah. You have another level of steps, hallelujah, to climb this morning, hallelujah. The things, hallelujah, that the God, hallelujah, of Israel, Isaac, Jacob, hallelujah, glory be to God, the God of Abraham has given you this morning, hallelujah. The Lord have your enemies so confused, hallelujah. It would not be until you're long gone and long established, hallelujah, that they'll be just beginning, hallelujah, to see where the Lord has you this morning. Glory be to the name of the Lord. So remain steadfast this morning and don't look back. And remember, hallelujah, forget not the marvelous works of the Lord, because He is performing deliverance. He is working it out for you this morning, hallelujah. And don't think of working it out just to get that house and that car and that material things, hallelujah. I'm talking about supernatural, hallelujah, supernatural things, hallelujah. I'm talking about, hallelujah, huge checks this morning, hallelujah. I'm talking about healing this morning, where you go to the doctor, hallelujah, and they tell you that, oh, this is too far gone, and the Lord turn it around, and you go back to the doctor, and he said this, he himself has to proclaim that this is a miracle, and you open up your mouth, you don't stay pinned and say, oh yes, doctor, I told you so. You open up your mouth and you said, yes, sir, this is a miracle from the Most High God that I serve. Don't say that this came through prayer, hallelujah, all this come because you give God the glory. Say that it is our God. It is my God, the Lord Jesus of miracles, of great wonders that has done this. Hallelujah. I could have prayed all I want. I could have speak faith all I want, but it is because of God, hallelujah, working upon me, hallelujah, by his miraculous grace that this has happened. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Forget not the wondrous works of the Lord this morning. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In 2 Kings 17 and 30, a jar of flour and all stayed full, hallelujah, during the time of famine, hallelujah, hallelujah. In 1 Kings 18, 30 through 46, the Holy Spirit showed up on Elijah, amen, and he was able to outrun chariots and horses. That is a miracle, hallelujah. Some of you, hallelujah, you are so burdened down with things, hallelujah. You feel that you can't move, that you can't get up, that you can't find your way, hallelujah. I encourage you, hallelujah, lay down on your face and you pray, hallelujah, in the Holy Ghost. And then you, when you get up, you say, Lord, I'm getting up in your strength, hallelujah. And you use the weapons of your warfare, hallelujah. You stand up like the child of the King as you are. And you speak to that situation and you said, Lord, you are a God of miracles. So God, perform your miraculous work right now. And you watch God move it. Hallelujah. For you this morning in the name of Jesus. I want to encourage you that these things too, again, I'm saying that these things too, having the strength of the Lord to overcome, that too is miracles. Hallelujah. Because if you don't use these miraculous things, especially as people of the apostolic, hallelujah, yes, these miracles, they should be used as your weapons of warfare to make you fight. Because as you continue to worship God for his miracles, you will continue to be strengthened, hallelujah. You will continue to use them like a bat and to use the word of God like a bat. And when the struggles come, hallelujah, like that baseball, you would be able to knock it, hallelujah, yeah, to this field, hallelujah, to left field, yeah, knock it to right field, hallelujah. And as we say in the realm of the spirit, as spiritual people, you will be able to cast that demon down to the pits of hell, hallelujah, where he belongs. Glory be to the name of, yes, the Lord. Hallelujah. Another major miracle, hallelujah, was the flood. Hallelujah. This flood, hallelujah, affirms both God's judgment on extreme wickedness and his grace and his promising, hallelujah, never again to destroy humanity so completely. Hallelujah. And so this flood, can you imagine the whole earth being flooded, hallelujah, yes, right now, hallelujah. The, wow, Lord promised not to do it again, but think about it then, hallelujah. That, of course, is a miracle when the Lord did that, hallelujah. All of those who were wicked and evil, they were destroyed. Glory be to the name, yes, of the Lord. That too, hallelujah, goes to show, yes, the Lord loves his people. Yes, the Lord loves humanity. And that's why he sent his son Jesus, hallelujah, to save us, hallelujah, that we don't have to go through that anymore. But with this miracle of the flood, it goes to show, hallelujah, the enemy and wickedness still will be condemned to judgment, hallelujah. Only what we do for Christ will last. It is only in living for Christ, hallelujah, that we shall inherit the promises of God, hallelujah. And so we can call, hallelujah, on the Lord anytime to send his flood, hallelujah, in the realm of the spirit, hallelujah, and wickedness, hallelujah. Like I said before in the examples, when the windows of heaven open, and just as how there is downpour of rain, there is downpour of blessings, hallelujah. This will destroy the enemy because they wouldn't be able to figure you out. Glory be to the name of the Lord, because blessings are overflowing upon your life. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Through the Lord, hallelujah, the Lord's power. Amen. And him speaking through the prophet Elisha now. Jesus. Hallelujah. He spoke to Nahum. Mm-hmm. And he told him to go and dip, hallelujah, in the River Jordan in order to be healed. Hallelujah. He put up a fuss. Amen. Over and over, many times the Lord speak through his prophets to many of you. And instead of going and doing what the prophet says, you find all kind of excuses. You have seen the prophet work. Yes. You have seen the deliverance work through, hallelujah, through the prophet. Yes. You have proven and tested the prophet. But yet, sir, you put up a fuss. Yes. You despise prophecy, hallelujah.
And the prophet.
I want to remind you that the hallelujah, the spirit of hallelujah of prophecy is the testimony of Jesus Christ. So when you are despising the prophecy and despising the prophet, hallelujah, it is Jesus himself you are despising, hallelujah. And eventually Nahum listened, hallelujah, and was healed. Glory be to the name of the Lord. But there is another side to this story, hallelujah, when it talk about being obedient, hallelujah. And we are talking about miracles, hallelujah. But we are also talking about warfare, hallelujah. Where the Lord, hallelujah, destroys, where the Lord delivers, where the Lord proves of his power, where the Lord redeems, hallelujah, so that our faith can be lifted up, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord, hallelujah. Gehazi, hallelujah, the servant, hallelujah, he went behind the prophet's back, hallelujah, and he went and steal, hallelujah, and take money, hallelujah, for his own riches, for his own gain, hallelujah, thinking that the prophet would not find out, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. I can think of a certain situations right now, glory be to the name of the Lord, where people who are serving God, they believe in the Bible, they believe in the word of God, hallelujah. They know that prophets exist, hallelujah. Some of them call themselves prophets, hallelujah, themselves. But yet, sir, when it comes, hallelujah, to the church and the things of the church, they go behind, hallelujah, and take what don't belong to them, hallelujah.
Oh,
they go behind, hallelujah, and dispense and disperse what should be to the church, or what should have been left alone and should be set up to build the church. They go behind, hallelujah, and take, hallelujah, and when they take, hallelujah, they use it for their own good, hallelujah, because if you take something that is in place, if there's a structure and something that is in place, in this case, the prophet, hallelujah, told him, hallelujah, the prophet knew his heart and knew what he was going to do. He was told not to go and take anything, amen, hallelujah. He warned and he was like, what? This man is rich and you perform this, he asks you to give you to give of you something and you didn't take, and you didn't take it. What? I'm gonna go and take this. I'm gonna get this. This ain't going nowhere. Amen. It's the same thing. Hallelujah. The people of God have structure in place. Hallelujah. And because they don't come, hallelujah, after you, they leave you and let you be. Hallelujah. Respecting you. I mean, giving you the honor, hallelujah, that you deserve and you rightly should be deserving of honor. Hallelujah. You go around and say, oh, they ain't checking. Oh, hallelujah. I'm gonna use this for this. I'm gonna use that for that. I'm gonna get this. I'm gonna do what I wanna do, which is out of the will of God. And then you expect, hallelujah, for the prophet, hallelujah, not to step in and say, I see you. You expect to step in, hallelujah, and you expect not to be cursed, hallelujah, when the prophet gave you a chance, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Or when you was given a chance, hallelujah, you was given a chance and did not do what you were supposed to do, hallelujah. You operate in your own understanding, hallelujah, according to your own will, hallelujah. and expect not to be cursed. Hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. And I want to remind, hallelujah, some of you out there that that is the power, hallelujah, of the prophet. When you are given a chance,
yes,
and another chance, hallelujah, and the prophet has initiated something, and you see, hallelujah, glory be to the name of the Lord, you were given grace, hallelujah. Regret and reject not what the prophet, hallelujah, has done for you. The prophet has the power, hallelujah, to pronounce curses just as well as Elijah did in this case, hallelujah. And it is not a curse, hallelujah, just for you. Hallelujah, it's not a curse just to be wicked, hallelujah, or just to destroy you or stop things, hallelujah. The fact is, you're the one who opened up the doorway for the curse to come upon you. It is to teach you a lesson, hallelujah. Gehazi, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. He, hallelujah, because of his dishonesty and his disobedience, hallelujah, he, hallelujah, became possessed with leprosy, hallelujah. Imagine the amount of curses, people of God, that you have opened up on your own life. The prophet doesn't have to pronounce it because God himself, hallelujah.
Jeez.
God himself, hallelujah, he said to choose what you want, whether you will choose blessings or curse. Amen. The prophet don't have to speak directly and say, oh, from this day so and so was going to happen to you because you didn't listen. The prophet doesn't have to do that. The fact is,
yes,
once you open up a doorway by being disobedient, not only that, by being dishonest, amen, you wonder why some people, even pastors and people of God, church attendants, you wonder why you look at them and they seem like they're in such disarray. You seem like there is no growth and everything for them is stagnant. Amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. You wondering why they look like things dry up. Amen. It's because of the doors they would have opened by, number one, not listening to the word of God and not listening, hallelujah, to the prophet or the prophetic word or the prophetic voice. The Lord doesn't have to speak to another man, hallelujah, in order for you to hear it. Sometimes the Lord speak to you himself, and if the prophetic word of the Lord come upon you and you choose not to listen,
Jesus,
hallelujah, then hallelujah, if it comes upon you and you're the one who choose not to listen, then you are cursing yourself, even as people of God. Glory be to the name of the Lord. And so it is a miracle, amen, when you can worship the Lord, when you can listen to his word, hallelujah, because many people are so stubborn and all they're doing is meeting their demise because of their stubbornness. So being saved, hallelujah, being led by the Spirit of God, that two people of God, is a miracle. And you know what? It helps, hallelujah, to destroy the works of darkness and the enemies, hallelujah,
amen,
around you. Glory be to the name of the Lord. So Jesus, hallelujah. Let us get back to Jesus now as I wrap up. Hallelujah. Jesus performed miracles in feeding the 5,000. He performed miracles by giving Jairus' daughter, hallelujah, life, hallelujah, healing a woman who was hemorrhaging, hallelujah, making those who were lame, hallelujah, to walk,
yes,
hallelujah, again. Glory be to the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. I just want to stop here and just remind you that as,
yes,
especially apostolic people or people, hallelujah,
yes,
who are operating or who are around and among the apostolic,
yes,
hallelujah, that miracles, not only miracles, signs and wonders,
yes,
glory be to God, should follow you.
Yes.
Amen. Apostle Paul said in 2 Corinthians 12 and 12, he says, I persevered in demonstrating among you the marks of a true apostle.
Yes.
Including signs, wonders, and miracles. If you see signs, wonders, and miracles, hallelujah, being performed through an apostle, hallelujah, and through the apostolic church, that is a mark, hallelujah, a,
yes,
sign that demonstrate to you that the Lord is moving and that the Lord is there. Amen.
Amen, Jesus.
Glory be to the name of the Lord. I want to leave with you. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 2, verses 16.
Yes.
And 21. It says, now what you see was predicted long ago by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit upon all people.
Yes.
Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions, and your old men will dream dreams. In those days, I will pour out my spirit even on my servants, men and women alike. Hallelujah. A lot of persons like to miss this part of the scripture. He said he will pour out the Holy Spirit on his servants, men and women alike. Amen.
Yes. Woo.
When the Spirit of the Lord is poured out upon you,
that's good.
There is something called the fruits of the Spirit. If the Spirit of the Lord has poured out his Spirit on you, then you should possess the fruits of the Spirit. If the Spirit of the Lord is upon you, hallelujah, then you should possess the gifts, hallelujah, of the Spirit. The Lord said that he will pour it out on all of his servants, men and women, and they will prophesy. And I will cause wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and clouds of smoke. Amen?
Amen.
The sun will become dark. We have already seen that through the lunar and the solar eclipse. Hallelujah. And the moon will turn to blood red.
Yes.
Before the great and glorious day of the Lord arrives. But everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. People of God, the Lord is always with you. He is your shield, buckler. Hallelujah, and your strength. Don't be moved by disgruntled people and distracting circumstances. If you know and believe in your God, your heart should be glad and you should praise him in every circumstances. Again, I say when God steps in, miracles, hallelujah, happens. But forget not the wonderful works or the wondrous works of the Lord. You shall live and not die. Hallelujah.
Yes.
The Lord, through his Holy Spirit, has shown your life. Hallelujah. How has shown you life. The Lord, through his Holy Spirit, hallelujah, and through, hallelujah, his house of ministry, has shown you how to live and how to be. Be careful to know that the joy of the Lord's presence is around you. Hallelujah. This way, you will not sin and you will not be defeated.
Amen.
And we ought to focus on the miracles of the Lord. Hallelujah. Then we will be reminded that the presence of the Lord, hallelujah, is around us. We will not sin. Hallelujah. And really and truly, hallelujah, we really, or how should I put it now? It shouldn't, as people of God, especially those who are spiritual, you don't need a brain scientist or binoculars to see when people aren't truly in God. Because if someone, well, even if they're attending church or not, amen, you see them backsliding or dipping or retracting, amen, you see them pulling away, you know that their mind ain't on God. You know that they don't recognize the presence of the Lord around them. Most importantly, they don't know and haven't come to recognize and realize who they are in God yet. You give them, hallelujah, breakthrough. You minister, you pray, hallelujah, with them. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And this is one of the things that the enemy uses. He uses people to come around, hallelujah, the men and women of God, especially those who are in the fivefold. Amen. Apostles, prophets, pastors, evangelists, teachers. He uses people to come around and pull on you. They will use your strength to pray with them all night, to deliver them. Amen. Mm. to perform deliverance and everything on them. Hallelujah. And then they continue to dwell on your strength instead of dwelling on their own and getting up and praying and reading the Bible and really remaining focused on God.
Yes.
When they feel like everything is good and they get breakthrough, now they want to stay home or go to another church, do whatever they want to do. Yes. And then when they feel like their spirit is down again, they come around and then they feed off of you again. Amen, because they don't want to stand on their own. And this is where a lot of the enemy is using a lot of people in the body of Christ, amen, to wear down other people. When there are others there who are really pushing and want breakthrough and they recognize the power of God and they give glory and honor, amen, to God, then those infiltrators, I would call them, they come around, hallelujah, and try to pull. It's time, hallelujah, that we start, especially as persons who are in charge of or responsible, I would say, for ministering the word of God and to equipping and building up, which should be all of us. Amen. Because as people of God, especially in the apostolic, we are to equip, to build up, to edify, amen, the saints. It's time for us, hallelujah, to allow persons to grow in God, hallelujah, for themselves, hallelujah, and also take a stand and rebuke them if they are not, moving, hallelujah, the way they should in Christ. You do so much for them, and yet so there's no improvement. It's because they're lazy, and they have that door open for the enemy to use them, and then the enemy to pull on you. So from this day on, hallelujah, that spirit of deception and that spirit of sucking, hallelujah, I cancel it over the people of God in the name of Jesus in the fivefold and even over the saints of God in the name of Jesus. The Apostle Paul says, work out your own salvation. Amen. You can call upon the Lord. He delivers now. He set free. He uses people, hallelujah, to lead you and to guide you. But when you are not around those people, you're responsible for yourself. You're responsible for seeking after God and being so much in God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That if the enemy comes and tries to push you, amen, to the ground, that you can stand solid, amen, on Christ. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You can remain grounded in Christ too, in the name of Jesus. And so, God bless all of you today. And as I leave, hallelujah, and as we pray, Father, we give you praise, glory, and honor for the one today who, Father, we are certain have gotten breakthrough and deliverance, Lord, not by my might, but through you, through your word, and through your Holy Spirit. I thank you for that faith that has been increased today, Lord God. And Father, now I come against and pull down, Lord God, the spirit of deception, Lord God, the spirit that seek to separate and disperse and to scatter, oh God, the saints of God who are in the church of God, Father, the spirit, oh God, that want to lay burden, oh God, upon your people, that they cannot push, that they cannot press, Lord God, we push them down, Lord God, we send them to the pits of hell in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Every strong man that is operating against your church and against your people, we bind them with heavenly chains, Lord God, and declare that hailstones of fire from heaven fall, Lord God, and destroy them now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Every, oh God, mindset that is not of you, Lord God, we, oh God, command it to be uprooted and go to the pits of hell. And every thinking, oh God, every thought, we bring it under the captivity of Jesus Christ right now in the name of Jesus. We release the spirit of joy, the spirit of worship, oh God, the spirit of praise upon your people today now, Lord God. And we declare that every yoke has been destroyed, Lord God, by your mighty power. We declare that now your people have been set free, Lord God. And as your word declare, hallelujah, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty, oh God. And whoever is in Christ, oh God, is a new creature. And once the Lord has set you free, we are free indeed, Lord. And so we give you praise, glory, and honor now, Lord God. In Jesus' precious and holy name, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Come on, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's stretch our hands, Father. We thank you for a wonderful word. We bless you for this wonderful word of deliverance and a miracle, signs and wonders. We hold you to your word of delivering God. We pray for prophetess Shalewa Cawley right now. Lord, cover her in your blood as she has delivered that which you have said to your people and to us today. She's released the power and glory. Pour all the virtue and glory of the Lord back into her. Fill her now in the mighty name of Jesus. If you're listening to this message, it's been a blessing. I know it has blessed you. I know it has touched you. The Lord is touching you even now. The Lord is ministering to you, listening and watching us around the world. We declare the power of the Lord be upon you. And if you've been blessed, we ask you to contact us, pray for us, stand with us, email us, call us on those numbers you're seeing now. You got a miracle. We stand with you today for a miracle from the Lord. As you believe, be it unto you according to your faith. Be healed in your body right now. Cancer cell, triumph. Viruses, bacteria, triumph. Body regulate, mind be regulated. We declare every demon, every power, every witch, every warlock, everything that's been held up by the enemy illegally be broken in the name of Jesus. And if you're not saved today, you need to know him as Lord and Savior. If you need to repent of your sins, we ask you to turn away from those sins right now. Give your life to the Lord. Get out of that situation. Get out of that shacky. Get out of that immoral, unclean, unholy living and relationship. Get to Jesus and surrender it all. And don't look back to sin. Don't look back to the world of sin. Pay your tithes like you should. Repent for not paying it. Repent for not giving the Lord his worship. Repent for not being faithful to the house of God. Repent for speaking against the house of God and the people of God and the leadership of God. Repent from running and being unfaithful to the house of God and to the things that you know God has called you to do. Running from him, being unfaithful to his house and to him as Lord. And when you repent and when you turn your heart and when you surrender it all, then the Lord can have room to move. Renounce Satan. Get that filthy things off your television. Get that filthy thing out of your listening and your hearing. Get those filthy words and that ungodly lifestyle. Get it out of your way and be set free. Get out that adultery. Get out that fornication. Get out of that smoking and drinking. Get out that immorality. Get out of that unrighteous relationship. Get out of it. Get away from that gossiping, scandaling, relationships and friends. Get out of that, hallelujah, false doctrine. Get out of that occult. Get these things out of the way and make Jesus Christ your Lord. Get in the Bible. Get into prayer. The house of God. The hour is late. Hell is real. And Satan wants to take you to hell. Satan wants to kill you. Satan wants to destroy you. He wants to hold up your miracle and your favor and your blessing. If you don't get under the covering, the enemy is going to try to kill you. I hear you. If you don't get out of that sin, the devil is going to try to kill you with that sin, and you're going to face a real hell. Get out now. Tomorrow is not good enough. Today is the day for your salvation. Listen to the word of the Lord that was declared prophetically by prophetess that I'm coming and reinforcing. Listen to the word of God. The hour is late. The hour is late. Time is late. These are the last and final days. Give your heart to Jesus. He is coming. He is coming. He is coming soon. This world as we know it is coming to an end. Jesus is coming. He wants to save you and give you a new life and save you eternally. But you must repent. The hour is late. The hour is late. God doesn't care about your money as much as he cares about your soul. Hallelujah. He can do any miracle instantly if you would give him your heart. If you would not go to idolatry. If you would not make that car an idol. If you would not make that house your idol. If you would not make that job, that money, that career an idol.
you and put him to the forefront every day, no matter what he gives or what he takes. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God, the God of Israel, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Jesus, the eternal Savior, the only Savior of the world, the only hope of salvation for humanity. I know you've been blessed. We want you to contact us, email us, find us on our website. Let us know that you've been blessed by this broadcast. We need to hear from you. We want to hear from you. We want to hear the testimonies. And our Father, we pray right now, those who are listening and watching, we declare the kingdom of God and the glory of the Lord to be upon this house, Cami Bahamas, and Cami Global, Kwame International, Kingdom Apostolic Global Network, upon the leaders, upon the house, upon every seed and gift and partner that support this ministry, right now in the name of Jesus. We give you praise, Lord, glory and honor. Amen. If you're being blessed, we ask you to contact us. Sow into this ministry. We are an apostolic, prophetic deliverance house. We don't play around. We believe the Lord Jesus, and we stand on his word and on his promises with no compromise. We are end-time prophets. We bring forth the word of the Lord to this dark generation. The hope of Jesus Christ. Amen. We want you to sow a miracle seed this morning. If you have a seed and you want to sow, we ask you to give your tithe, your offering that belongs to the Lord. And your offering, we want you to sow a miracle offering. Hallelujah. Everybody get a miracle offering. The Lord put in my heart to sow a miracle. I want you to bring the Holy Ghost and ask the Holy Ghost what you should sow. Kingdom Apostolic Ministries, those who are listening and watching around the world. Hallelujah. I want you to sow a special seed, a miracle seed into this house, into this ministry this morning. And as you sow it, I declare it as a prophet. You're going to get a healing. You're going to get a deliverance. You're going to get a miracle in your life and your mind. Someone who needs to be saved will be saved on a seed you sow today. You need a financial breakthrough. You need a miracle in your life. You need a supernatural outpouring of the Holy Spirit. It's about to happen. As you sow, so believe it. Cast your bread upon the water. For in many days it shall come back unto you. Give and it shall be given unto you. Press down. Overflow it. Shall man give to your bosom. I want you to sow a financial seed, a gift, an offering unto the Lord, to this house, into this anointing this morning. This miracle month. Sow into this miracle month. Sow today on this word, a miracle word, and watch the Lord do a thousands of dollars worth of debt cancellation. That's it, Lord. I declare it today. Even as you sow, within the next 24 hours, I declare an answer for debt freedom comes. I declare every business venture as you sow this morning shall come to pass in 24 hours. 24 hours, you will see a miracle. A business, a financial debt, a pain that you have in your back. I declare now the Lord heals your back, heals your neck, heals your leg. I declare headaches be broken, migraines, sinus congestion be broken, throat infection, throat pain, chest pain, insomnia, inability to sleep. I break it. Even as you sow a seed, you will sleep. Hallelujah. The indigestion, gastric reflux, we break it now. In the name of Jesus, some of you believe in God for a baby and for children. You need to sow. I hear the Lord saying, you will be pregnant. He will cause it to happen supernaturally in the name of Jesus. Some of you men, you believe in God for a home, for your family. You believe in God for a miracle. Bring it now. Bring it now in Jesus' name. Sow it to Kingdom Apostolic Ministries International. You believe in God for a miracle. You believe in God for a miracle. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Be blessed today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come on, worship him. 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 Come on and worship the Lord. 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 Hear my shout.
So delighted that you took the time with your family and your loved one to tune into this broadcast, Kingdom Impact Production. We have been doing all we could to get this gospel of the kingdom out. I pray that this message really transform your heart, that you would spend some time today reflecting on it. You will go to your Bible and go through and study what was taught. and really implement those things. The Lord has a great purpose for your life. We are standing with you. Here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries, we request your prayer, your financial support. Please visit us on our website. Please see us on the various mediums that will come up on this site. And follow us. I would love to hear from you. Please email, call, Skype me, all the methods you can. Please let us know that you're with us praying for us, and be a blessing if you can. Please bless us with any donation. No donation is too big or too small. Again, God bless you. We look forward to you joining us again for another presentation. Amen.